the TDP Supremo, I call him as very inefficient for the simple reason he has been in the power for the last 4 years, both at the central as well as the state. He could not get what the people of Andhra Pradesh is asking for, that is the special status. He has been in power for almost for 3.5 years, both at the state as well as the center. It is extremely unfortunate. I call him extremely inefficient. Instead of special status, he has been satisfied the special package, a strange phenomena doing a great harm to the people of Andhra Pradesh. So the manifesto of Chandrababu Naidu, as many as 600 false promises have made, unfortunately there is no law to curtail. If the manifestos, any promise are made in the manifesto, is very unfortunate, parliamentary democracy is ours. There is no watchdog to control or to implement the promises made by any particular party once they come into the power. Ms. Chandrababu Naidu has made 600 false promises. To quote few, sir, he said that unconditional waiver of all farm loans. As on today with the interest, the farm loans are 80,000 crores. He could give only a pity 8,000 crores as against 80,000 crores. Is a great fraud on the farmers of Andhra Pradesh, where 90% of the farmers are in debt in Andhra Pradesh. Out of 1 lakh farmers, 90% of the farmers are in debt. So you would have asked at least the government of India to come to his rescue and help the farmers of Andhra Pradesh. And he also said that all the Dwakara loans will be waived off. The outstanding amount on the Dwakara loans are 30,000 crores. He could not do anything for that except that a petty amount of 300 crores he has given to them, 3,000 crores. Similarly, he promised every household one job if he comes to the power. He has mentioned in the manifesto, it is unfortunate, now 3.5 years are over, still a poor man is looking up to get one job in each family. And he also promised, if he can't give the job, he promised that 2,000 rupees would be given as a compassionate amount. That also is not given one family, sir. And he has promised to the BC community 10,000 crores, a separate budget. And he did not see the light of the day till day 3.5 years are over. And he promised the waiver of the loans of these weavers. Again, great injustice has been done. Nothing has been done to them. And he promised every woman a smartphone. He did not give one single phone to any woman, sir. So ungrateful to the women, so ungrateful to the youth, so ungrateful to the farmers, so ungrateful to the BC people, so ungrateful to the weavers, and every place. And he also promised the houses for every poor man. During last 3.5 years, I have toured as many as 1,300 villages, sir. And he also promised that every road will be converted into CC road in villages. Zero. And Narega, where the government of interest will come into that, sir. Does the government of India know? Now I'm coming to this topic as well, sir. 10 schemes of Andhra Pradesh, state schemes, are being run by the amount given by the government of India under Narega. It's a diversion of funds, and not only diversion, sir, it is hitting on the belly of a poor man, sir. Under Narega, the people below the poverty line, whoever asks, a minimum 150 days should be given the wages and the work for them. I have attended any number of mandal meetings, sir. No mandal has ever implemented the 100% of that scheme. And hardly 30% of the people below the poverty line are able to get the wages. How harmful. He is doing a great injustice to the poor people. And whereas the former Chief Minister, YS Rajasekhar Reddy, 90% of that Narega funds have gone in the form of the wages. The Andhra Pradesh state government is making some of the government machinery like district administration, the chief secretary, and the finance secretaries very ineffective, because the Janmabhoomi committees, which are flooded with Telugu Desam people, are deciding, including on the houses being allotted by the government of India, are being decided by the Janmabhoomi committee, constituted unconstitutionally by the government of Andhra Pradesh. I seek the permission and I sought upon the government of India to institute a CB inquiry against the government, the present government of Andhra Pradesh, to get into these details. And the anti-defection law, it's existing on paper, it's zero in Andhra Pradesh. As many as 24 MLAs he bought outright. And out of 24 MLAs, 4 MLAs have been made as the ministers, unprecedented in democracy in any of the state. And he himself was, Supremo TDP was also caught on telephone conversation in the election of MLC in Telangana. Vote for no, cash for vote. And to overcome that, to avoid the embarrassment, as again as 10 years he's supposed to be in Hyderabad, he has to leave the place to Amaravati within an year to overcome this CB inquiry, and it amounts to match fixing. What happened to that, sir? The same anti-defection law? Our MP, one of the MLAs, a lady MLA, for no reason, sir, she has banned the entry of into assembly almost for 3 years. And despite the court orders, she was not allowed to enter into the assembly. It's extremely unfortunate. So therefore, they must think twice before throwing the mud on the others. The TDP MP should not have commented such a way. It's very unfortunate, sir. And he also spent, unfortunately, sir, again the government of India should note, 2,000 crores on Pushkarams. When the state government is reeling under the deficit budget and is seeking these funds from the government of India of 16,000 crores, he's spending on Pushkaram, sir, on one Pushkaram at Rajamundry, where 29 people died, and the reason is the Honorable CM. For the simple reason, he's not supposed to take a bath at a particular ghat, and he took it there, depriving the people. After he left, there was a stampede which has resulted in the death of the 29 people, merely because of the CM, and this is shame for him. And Amaravati, sir, the combined state, when it was combined, Andhra and Telangana, almost for 70 years, the entire state secretariat and the assembly, both legislative and the council, was existing in just simple 3.5 acres, and it was extremely successful. The present government of Andhra Pradesh has acquired 35,000 acres fertile lands of Krishna and Godavari areas. It's very unfortunate, and depriving the farmers of their legitimate livelihoods. And forgetting about all these, he is finding fault with our leader. It's very, very unfortunate, and we want those words to be expunged. Sir, coming to the point, sir, the government of India, sir, in this budget, we appreciate, sir, these 50 crore people will be covered by the insurance. But let me also point out, in 2016, Rashtriya Bhima Yojana, they said that 1 lakh insurance would be given to the people. And I don't think that a single person has been covered under the insurance one. And 2017, again, a new insurance scheme with a cover of 30,000. And they have promised that they would be covering 26 crore people. I'll come to that later. They promised to cover the 26 crore people, and unfortunately, till 21 crore people below the poverty line had to be covered. Now this year they come up with a very big plan of 10 crore families with 50 crores. So I request the Honorable Minister, who is very efficient and a man of consciousness, before making any of the schemes, the poor people should not be hit below the belt. I really request right. One last few points, sir. Really request him to look into that one, sir. And coming to this MSP also, sir, perhaps eyeing on the coming elections, I am sure that 1.5 times the MSP is given to the farmers. Wonderful, sir. And they have not indicated the term, and they have not indicated both the crops, Kharif and as well as the Rabi. But here the critical point is that unless the MSP is properly fixed, there is no point in giving 1.5 times again. This is again a false promise, sir. I request the Honorable Minister kindly that MSP should be fixed critically, taking all aspects into considerations. Then only that 1.5 times of the Swaminathan Committee would be fulfilled. Sir, one more point which I would like to request the Honorable Minister, sir. This one word I would like to suggest that Honorable Minister of Finance, sir. Sir, there is a lot of disparity in India, of the income disparity. The rich is becoming richer. That's what every time the opposition parties say that is corporate and all that. Why can't the Honorable Minister of Finance consider universal basic income principle? When the disparity is increasing so much, 1% of the people in India are cornering the benefits of the 75% of the national's wealth in the form of the loans and these lands and the water and these nominated positions and the judges and everything. Why can't the government give every family a minimum of 5,000 per month for each family? The ODF, they are really taking credit for it, sir. As I already mentioned that, sir, 1,300 villages I have seen. It is extremely ineffective. One point, sir. It is very ineffective for the simple reason that fecal management principle is not being followed. No toilet is being put into use for the purpose it has been created. So right. I request that also should be considered.
Right, right.
And the last point, sir. Since the government is going all the way to waive the NPS and all that, finding several ways to overcome that, similarly, which is not even 1/5 of the NPAs, is the farmers' loans, which comes to, after all, 3 lakh crores. If the government of India thinks, let them help each and every small and marginal farmers by waiving the entire farm loans of the country, and the government will remember forever and ever. And the last one, sir, we again request the special status category for Andhra Pradesh. And do justice for the people of Andhra Pradesh. Thank you very much, sir, for giving me this wonderful opportunity. Thank you so much.